We're looking at a big old desk full of goodies this month. A lot of car stuff coming out. So I'm going to have a look and show you guys what's come in from our nice sponsors. Then we're going to come back with some stuff I've picked up for the personal stash and things I wanted to get a hold of for this month. First up, some stuff in from Revell USA. Check it out. It's back out. The 1/24th scale 1969 Dodge Super B with my favorite muscle car engine in it by far. The 446 pack. So it is a sweet looking kit. It's a 2-in-1. We'll have quite a few options on it. 86 pieces. Remember, 1/24th scale in that monogram red, white, and blue boxing. All kinds of options inside there. We'll be building this one up for sure because it's one of my favorite cars and I absolutely love it. The 1956 Chevy Delray, another 2-in-1, stock and custom buildup. Take a look at that box, still wrapped in the shrink wrap, reflecting back. This one's in 1/25th scale, skill level 5, 153 parts in this bad boy. So this is a little bit higher skill level. We're definitely going to be able to build this one up, make it look pretty sweet. So on that one, I might want to do a mix of custom and stock. We haven't seen this kit out in quite a while. The Chevy S10. Called the Street Sleeper. Now, let's be honest, what this is pretty much a stock S10 body over the Cyclone or Typhoon drivetrain. It's the turbocharged 4.3 all-wheel drive. It's in 1/25th scale, skill level 4, 120 parts. It's going to make for a fun kit. I can't wait to decide what I'm going to be doing with that S10, but definitely want to get that built up. Tip this box back here. It's just, it wants to get on screen so bad. It's so excited. From Salvino's JR through Model Roundup. Model Roundup sent this over. It's the 81 through 84 when they raced them. Pontiac Le Mans stock car. Now this one, why is it black? Why is there no cool emblems on it? Why is the side all white? Well, this kit does not have any decals in it. You can order it plain Jane. You don't have to order it with the decals. It saves you some money. And from Model Roundup, you can pick up your own set of decals for it. Now, I'm going to be doing the JD Stacy number 28 car. These are power slide decals. You can see how awesome and beautiful these things are. They always go on well. It's the same kind of decals that are in the kit stock, but with these cars, the no-name cars, you can pick your own. You can decorate your own car. They've got the skull car. They've got all the cool stuff on that available. That one's going to be getting a build-up with those decals. The 92 Pontiac Grand Prix. All right. This, I have this in its original boxing sitting on a shelf, and I can't wait to get a chance to build it up. Now, you saw on the HPI Guys Workshop Facebook page that Salvino's has sent over the vermilion decal sets for all the petty cars. So go over there, look at those. I'm going to be using that to help build this car. So I should only really have to spray one color or so on the body and use the decals to do all the rest for me, which should make life a lot easier. This is in 1/24th scale, sent to me by Model Roundup to be used up for a full buildup. And you know I love petty, so I'm definitely going to be doing it. Back here, we're not going to get to this one just yet. Just calm down, guys. You'll see it in a little bit. From round two, 2006 Nissan 350Z. The 95 Supra was a big hit. You guys liked the unboxing of the Eclipse. Now we've got the 350Z. It's multiple parts in here. We've got optional racing seats. We got that gorgeous interior, which can be done Japanese or English drive, right or left-hand drive. Spoilers, all kinds of cool stuff on there. That one I'm leaning towards a build-up, but we'll see. Now, what is this? Well, that doesn't look like your standard model box. It's not. This is one of the first times we're going to be doing this on a channel. This is a full resin custom kit from a new channel sponsor. Sponsor doesn't mean that they throw us money or tell us what to do. It just means that they're nice enough to send a kit to lower my costs for the show, and that is it. New sponsors are always welcome to send kits, but that's, we don't accept anything else but the kits. ANN Model Trucks out of Latvia. The Power W, they can't put the brand name in the name when they sell it online because it makes it hard for licensing. But look what it is. It's a Power Wagon. And the new ones. How often do you see a brand new vehicle being made into a model kit. This is a full resin kit. They sent me the full option kit with the full fancy suspension and the engine, so it's not just a curbside. They are in 1/24th scale because they are from Europe and that's their most popular scale, but this beautiful monster-sized truck, this Ram Power Wagon, will be getting a full build-up. These are pricier kits, but once we take a look at this, I'm going to be doing an unboxing of this before I build it, just to get your chops all wetted for it. These things are amazing. I've had the box open. It is unbelievably detailed. So, what's next on the table? Well, you see a bunch of models from ICM. ICM is usually known as a military model company, but they do branch into all kinds of things, and they have decided to send product to the show now so we can take a look, and there's going to be everything in their line that you guys can enjoy. First up, we're going to be taking a look at the 1913 Model T Speedster with vintage figures. This is actually being worked on right now. I am working on this kit right now. I had a cool idea for it and wanted to get to it right away. Sent over by ICM, 1/24th scale. They make gorgeous military models, and the level of detail when I open this box, I've built some of their military kits and they're amazing, and so are their car kits. They also sent one of their new releases, the Soviet fire truck. 1/35th scale, so it goes with military dioramas, but that doesn't matter. It builds into a big, awesome kit. They also release this in their Chernobyl diorama. It's just outstanding. When you can get a hold of ICM kits, do it, because the level is amazing. Speaking of Chernobyl, it was a beautiful show on HBO about the Chernobyl incident, and ICM is releasing model kits to commemorate the large sacrifice by the people that worked on Chernobyl to keep everyone, in fact, everyone in the world safe from all the nuclear radiation and dust. This is when they were on the rooftops scraping up the radioactive waste. It's going to come with a cardboard diorama, the figures. We'll get this unboxed and let you take a look at everything that's in it. Back here, their gorgeous new Stearman kit in 1/32nd scale. I really want to build this up. It builds into a nice size airplane in the blue and yellow training scheme. I love it. It's 1/32nd scale, so it's not a little pin-sized model. It's got a bunch of, I've opened this one. I was too excited. I had to rip this one open as well and take a look. Beautiful parts. So when I'm feeling a little plane-ish, we're going to get this beautiful biplane on screen and take a look at it. What else we got from ICM? For you historical guys, way back in the day, we've got their Civil War Union Infantry and their Civil War Confederate Infantry figure sets. 1/35th scale to go with other military accessories and dioramas. You've got four figures in there for the Confederate side, and you've got four figures for the American side, for the Union side. So you can build up a really nice looking diorama with their other cannons and stuff that are available. So we'll be unboxing those, probably gluing the figures together. You can see how they look, getting them primed and everything. Now, I'm going to be switching over, get everything off the table, and switch over to some personal stuff that I picked up this week. I like to collect models, I like to build models, and something I saw recently on sale, it was less than 30 bucks on sale, this giant howitzer mobile cannon, the Panzerhaubitze 2000, level 4, 316 parts and 1/35th scale. I love building armor kits. I don't know if I'll just be having this in the background till I get slow one day or what, but I had to pick this thing up. It's absolutely giant and it's so cool looking. It'll be a good match for my Tamiya 1/35th American howitzer. Check this out. I know you guys like seeing some of the stuff I like to collect. I found this on eBay. 1986 Dodge Ram van from Home Alone, the old clay plumbing van. I'll be taking this out of the box and showing it on the Facebook page so you guys can see it. But it's adorable boxing, comes with its own carrying case, and is 1/43 scale. And it looks, it's even got like the slushy dirt mess on the bottom. It is outstanding for a collectible model. Off eBay, I've always wanted this kit, and it finally was low enough in a price. They were running a little bit of a rebate, that eBay bucks deal. The Fifth Element Corbin Dallas Taxi. Now, I'll open this up real quick in case you're thinking about buying these from eBay. It's a giant slug of resin, and the molding quality is quite low. I mean, you could tell I didn't know this, but unfortunately it is a copy of a copy. The real one should have had a separate grill and some other smaller separate parts. It's not too bad. I'll be able to work on it to replicate the taxi, but everything about this says it's a knockoff. The decals are copies of copies, but we'll at least build it up and make it look nice for a nice episode. This, I saw this advertised on Facebook randomly, and I tried to find it, found it on eBay. Suyata's Titanic port scene and vehicle. In this box is a little character size kit. We'll get a look at it. Only 50 millimeters long. It's these, you know, these tune kits from Meng. This is now the Titanic, but that's not all that's in the box. What's also in the box that got me excited was it includes the port that it left from, the little tiny buildings, and a steampunk airship. Total steampunk thing going on. And this eBay seller throws in wooden decks. You can see the cute little shape of the Titanic. They put in the wooden decks in the box for you. You can kind of see the cityscape diorama here, the little airship and all that stuff. So this will be another one in the dead of winter, which is coming up. We'll throw this up for an episode just to have a little bit of fun. Now, in the back here, I picked this up a while ago and I never got it on the show. I know this isn't a Lego channel and this won't be built on the channel, so don't worry about it. But just so you folks know it's out there, this has to be, aside from the Ghostbusters firehouse, which I have two of, this has to be the coolest Lego set I've ever seen in my entire life. You build a television on a stand, console TV with antenna. You build a video game, the Super Mario Brothers Duck Hunt game, the controller, and the console itself. And on the side is a crank to move Super Mario back and forth and have him jump over things. I had to have this. This is getting pretty hard to find already, and I've had it for maybe a month or two, sitting in the storage room waiting. We won't be building it on the channel because I don't build a lot of Lego on the channel anymore, but you should know this is out there if you didn't already, and see if you can snag one for yourself for Christmas or for someone you love, because if they're familiar with the NES, they're gonna lose their minds when they open that box. I got one more thing to show you, and I'll be right back. Well, you can see me reflecting in the box. What the heck am I doing here? No, I'm not going to be cooking stuff on the show. Dehydrators have become a good way for a lot of people to dry their model cars, and I build quick, and I'd like to build even more. So I ended up picking this up. We have a local, if you live in the upper Midwest, you know of a dealer called Fleet Farm or Blaine's Farm and Fleet. They're two different stores, but they have the general same kind of merchandise. They ran this gorgeous 10 tray food dehydrator on sale last week, and I had to snatch it up. Compare what I paid to this for the 200 and some dollars that places like, what do they call, Micromark want to rip you off for a dehydrating cabinet. It's got an opening door. It's not the circular. It's got 10 trays you can remove and stack up. It's got a temperature gauge to set your exact temperature, and you are all set when you can heat up your paint bottles. You can heat up your bodies, and when you're done painting them, you put them in here, turn it on 100 degrees, and leave it on for a few hours, and it will dry your paint jobs rock hard, no matter what kind of paint you're using. So I wanted to give this a shot. I got it for dirt cheap. I didn't have to pay the insane prices at places like Micromark, who take a food dehydrator, slap their sticker on it, and charge you $300 for. This thing was under 100 spot with tax and everything. So we're looking forward. I'm going to let you know how this is working. I'm going to start including it in some reviews just so you can see how it works and let you know if the hype is all there. I'll probably talk about it more on the Facebook page than I will in the videos, so you can keep an eye on that to see how this is working out for me. Thanks for watching the workshop. This is all the stuff out that I have for November. Any little things that trickle in will be shown on the Facebook page, and we will see all of you at the next review.